Hello, my name is Erin, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to edit PDFs with Adobe Acrobat DC's comment and markup tools. This tutorial is an update to my 2015 tutorial on the same subject. I'm creating this update because Adobe has modified Acrobat DC's comment and markup tools since my original tutorial was published. I have also improved some of the information originally presented. Before we begin, I'd like to share an important note about editing in Acrobat. Acrobat's comment and markup tools can't change a PDF like the Track Changes tool in Microsoft Word can change a Word file. Instead, Acrobat's comment and markup tools function like handwritten editing marks on paper. The tools can be used to mark what should be changed, but you have to make those changes manually in the original PDF. Therefore, you should use these tools on a secondary copy of your PDF. There are several ways to access Acrobat DC's comment and markup tools. I think the easiest way is to select the Tools tab and then select the comment icon from the Tools Center. The comment and markup tools should now appear in the toolbar, and the comment pane should appear on the right side of your screen. Now let's take a look at the tools that are the most relevant to editing. These tools are the sticky note, the highlight, the strike through, the add note to replace text tool, and the insert text at cursor tool. The sticky note lets you stick a note anywhere in the document. You can even move it around if you want to. The Highlight tool lets you highlight specific text. And if you want to add a note, right-click on the highlighted text and select Open Pop-up Note. The Strike Through tool lets you place a line through text that you want to mark for deletion. Once again, if you want to attach a note, right-click on the Strike Through text and select Open Pop-up Note. Similar to the Strike Through tool, the Add Note to Replace Text tool lets you mark text for deletion. But this time, Acrobat opens the pop-up note automatically for you to write the replacement text. Finally, the Insert Text at Cursor tool lets you insert text into any editable block of text. To use this tool, click the location where the new text should be inserted, and then write the new text in the pop-up note, which will appear automatically. If you want to close the comment and markup tools and the comment pane when you're done editing, select the X on the right side of the toolbar. From an editing perspective, the most important change to Acrobat DC's comment and markup tools is the elimination of the Shortcut tool. Previously, you had to select the Shortcut tool to automatically mark text for insertion, deletion, and replacement. However, in the latest version of Acrobat DC, you don't have to select a tool to automatically mark text for insertion, deletion, or replacement. All you have to do now is open the comment and markup tools. To create an insertion, place your cursor wherever you want the new text to appear in an editable text box, and then start typing. The new text will appear automatically in a pop-up note. To create a strike through, select the text you want to mark for deletion, and then press your delete key. And to insert replacement text, select the text you want to mark for replacement, and then start typing the new text, which will appear automatically in a pop-up note. If someone else has left comments or markups on your document or a group document, you may want to watch my other tutorial titled How to Reply to Comments and Markups in Adobe Acrobat DC. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see this tutorial in written format, please visit my corresponding blog post linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if you have a question about Adobe Acrobat or Microsoft Word that you'd like me to address in a future video. And please subscribe for more tutorials on writing, editing, and document software.